Hey guys, what's up? Bisectatron here from OneHive Gazette, here with the next video, and today we're taking a look at some LaLoon attacks, Town Hall 10, 11, and 12, to kind of show you guys this new trend. We're seeing more LaLoon, and it's working against a lot of bases that are otherwise set up to defend against the Wall Wrecker and maybe ground pushes. This is a very nice way to grab some relatively easy 3-stars. So we'll get to that in just a moment. You guys are probably a little curious about the war, and it was a blowout. Wasn't even close. And gotta give credit where credit is due to buy forever. I just noticed we didn't use two of our attacks. That was one of our 10s, so not that big of a difference probably. Certainly didn't help, but they did great. They had a perfect war, which is very, very difficult to do. And we struggled, hit pretty poorly 10v10. Only good thing was our 11v11 wasn't bad, considering that we had to dip so much on the 10s. The 11s did pretty well. 12s, you know, it wasn't the best war, but I think this isn't anything that is going to be permanent. I think Clan is still adjusting in terms of, we had some members come back that thought they might leave. Now we have a few members back from last season, stuff like that. So I won't go into too much detail about that. But I just thought I'd kind of go over the war a little bit and show you guys that it was a tough loss to buy forever. But they really put up a good effort, and it probably wouldn't have mattered anyway, even if we were on our game. There's not much you can do against a perfect war besides get a perfect war yourself, which is not easy to do. But looking at these LaLoon attacks, we're going to start at Town Hall 12. I want to show a few of theirs because they had some very, very nice LaLo triples. At Town Hall 12 particularly, I like the Suicide Battle Blimp because at Town Hall 10, Town Hall 11 even, it's too valuable almost to use as a Suicide Battle Blimp because it's that max battle blimp with max balloons in it. That's a lot to use just to lure the CC, take out an Inferno in an air defense. But at Town Hall 12, you have much more troop space. You have that same level balloons anyway. So you're not, relative to what you have, you're not expending as much to do that opener. So it kind of makes more sense. You're not using like your most powerful stuff at the beginning necessarily. So it's a very good way to get the CC lure, kind of take out a very strategic part of the base, and then just use the Warden, Hounds, Loons, nice Skelly for the Queen there. I think she kind of starts hopping around here, but the Skellies are going to go for the wall, and without the Bomb Tower, I think they will get to her eventually, so that works out pretty nicely. There's also a few Lava Pups that might help, but the Balloons just march through the base. Nice job using the Heroes to take out the Town Hall. Honestly, that is a great formula. If you can use the Battle Blimp to grab like Inferno, Air Defense, something of that nature, something valuable like that, and then use the Heroes to get the Town Hall, that's a great great way to start off the attack. I think the Town Hall at Town Hall 12 should always be used, at least not on the outside of the base, personally, for defensive purposes, because you're allowing the Sui Hero attack to grab the Town Hall, which is one of your most valuable defenses. I'd say by far your most valuable defense at Town Hall 12. So anyway, that is that. We'll take a look at one more 12v12, then a couple 11s and a 10 or so. So this one, also, of course, a LaLoon. That's the theme of this video. But now we're going to the opposite end of the spectrum. This is a humongous kill squad push. We're having healers, bowlers, a golem, I think a ground warden, just a very small LaLo for the back end, has a battle blimp, and a hound and like 13 loons, so not big by any means on the LaLo. Nice baby dragon there, hops in there, grabs the cannon, might even get this Tesla, we'll see, maybe not, goes down too quickly. Starts off with the queen here. Queen's a pretty good way to take out the town hall. You will have to keep her raged up most likely because the town hall does start to kill her pretty quickly. But actually right here, even without that rage at the end, I think she will get that town hall taken out. And of course the explosion typically won't affect her because she'll be so far away. So great value. He's going to have to use the queen's ability here to switch that damage off. But now the golem's going to do the tanking. The queen will sit back. Might even be a healer switch if he's lucky here. The healers might switch on to the golem or the bowlers or something. Everything pushing forward. Has the jump spell. Funnel is kind of already made there. The double walls push everything into the core towards the eagle. Nice freeze on the Inferno. Bringing freezes is a great thing to do for kill squads, no matter what town hall, what attack you're doing. You don't want the Inferno locking onto your high HP heroes, Golem, Wall Wrecker, whatever it is. The Queen does an interesting thing. She goes all the way outside the base here, which is honestly fine. She'll start cleanup and help on that Archer Tower a little bit. But a great, great push with this kill squad. Tremendous, tremendous push. Kind of went past the Inferno, but that's honestly okay. It's not that big of a deal for the balloons to handle. The important thing is, you know, getting in there, clearing out the Wizard Tower, I think a few Expos, just making it nice and easy on these balloons. Only has a couple hastes for them, but that's pretty much all he needs. A nice back end balloon to kind of help tank that Wizard Tower. And like I said, the Queen doing a great job on cleanup. And if she wasn't on cleanup, she would have otherwise helped with the defenses. So really, this was a triple almost inevitably once this plan was set in motion. So good stuff, good stuff. Got to give credit to their attacks. They were hitting somewhere like 60, 70%, I don't know. Very high 12v12 stats for them. And that's going to win you a lot of wars. It didn't even matter that their 10s and 11s did well as well, because the 12s kind of were already going to secure them the victory, assuming they performed that well, even if the 10s and 11s didn't. So good stuff, good stuff. Let's switch on to some of our attacks, because I want to show some nice 11v11s we had. Like I said, the 11s were kind of, you know, they weren't like anything like super impressive, but they were definitely solid for us. And it was encouraging to see that our Town Hall 11's doing pretty well, despite being thin, having to dip and everything. Now, I think it was King James. I might be wrong, and I apologize if I am. But one of our clan members, one of our 11s, was at a bar, apparently, when a girl near him just hit attack on his phone. That's what he told us. You know, who knows? Maybe he forgot his warden, but he didn't have a full army, didn't have the plan completely down. I think he was just scouting a base, as you often do when you know have the army kind of partially cooked up. You're still thinking about what troops to bring exactly, just kind of getting the details down. But you have the basic idea. Then all of a sudden he finds himself having to attack. He didn't start the attack for like the first 30 seconds or maybe 15 seconds. So we counted down for a little while, went to like 2:45. Everyone's wondering what's going on. He doesn't have his warden. The plan looks weird. But it just really sucked. So, you know, what are you going to do? Some things happen. It probably wouldn't have affected the outcome of the war considering the big star difference there was in the end. But things like that can happen. So it's kind of a funny story. I believe it was King James. But anyway, this was a nice triple. And the Queen charge, I believe the Town Hall was on the same side, but don't be afraid to use those wall breakers. There was so much value in the, I think a triple wall break, kind of one to enter in, one to let her into the next compartment over, then one to push a little deeper into the base. And yeah, great value, even though the Queen doesn't even survive the attack, which oftentimes is what you almost need to have happen. Still gets it done. Might have been a little bit tight on time here, but has enough to finish off the base. So good, good stuff to King James. Fun attack to watch. And yeah, if the Queen charges there, oftentimes people will give you some great value because they're setting up the side with the Town Hall, you know, not really thinking about anything coming from there because it's all Wall Wrecker, Wall Wrecker, Wall Wrecker that's dominating. But if the value's there, just take it old-fashioned, no wall wrecker, just do the Queen charge, even do a kill squad with like a jump spell, and you can maybe use the battle blimp or no siege machine at all. Because people are getting pretty extreme in how they build their bases, so there's some great value to be gotten on the Town Hall side very often. Moving along, we have another Sui hero, but this time a Town Hall 11-1. Good value here from the King and the Queen. King is going to grab at least one of those Teslas. Yeah, I think just that one, but does a good job tanking. Queen steps up, two Wizard Towers, I think maybe an Archer Tower in the mix as well, and kind of creating a bit of a funnel here. That's very important. The funnel, this is more of a spam LaLoon deployment. Not to say it's not to take away any of the skill of it. It has to be very well planned. The loon drops have to be good. Spread the balloons out nice and everything. But in this case, it wasn't like a clockwise, counterclockwise. It was a wave. And you can do that if you have enough balloons and enough hounds. I like how he had the siege machine, the battle blimp, cut across the base. It wasn't like a great way to use it, but having it cut across the base is good because it tanks and the balloons come out and they reinforce the group near the town hall. So that was a nice touch, making use of where the town hall ended up being. And then the balloons just kind of end up where they end up, you know, has a hound left up, which the Inferno will pop, which is actually good. You know, at this point you want that hound to pop to help with cleanup. And then these last few balloons moving in. So I'm a fan. You know, if you can come at a very compact base, and if there's good balloon pathing, you can get some good sui value. You might as well go for it. So great, great stuff there to ASAP tank. And we will advance on to one more 11v11, and then we'll do just one 10v10. 10v10, we're not seeing quite as much Lalo as we are Town Hall 11, Town Hall 12. It's more ground, but we did have one attack that I wanted to show. So this one, once again, is very minimal with the heroes, just Sui. The queen actually gets targeted right away, but that's not a big deal. It's 1 point defense. Gonna have to use the ability anyway. So the king will step up, grab the archer tower, and then the queen will get the archer tower and the air defense there. Look how close it is on her health there. As soon as that cannon turned, he knew he had the ability because one shot probably would have killed her at that point. But once again, some very good value. Wizard towers are always good things to get, especially ones that are not near air defenses, which in this case, I guess, is all of them on this base here. And then this is going to be similar to the last attack in that it's very, it's like an entire side of the base where the deployment's happening. I like the use of the battle blimp there, although he could have let go a little bit farther to soak up some traps. That's one thing to point out. You don't always want your battle blimp to go like in a straight line to the town hall, then like deploy the lava hound and have it continue in a straight line. Sometimes it's worth it to have, if you have a lava hound in your battle blimp, to have it kind of go farther in the base, then you deploy it and the hound comes like back. So that way you're kind of scoping out more of the base to pick up air traps and everything, let you know, really get the value of that battle blimp. So you can let it go even past the air defense, then have that lava hound come back to it. I mean, that way you're really clearing out the base for all those red air bombs, black mines, because the battle blimp, once you deploy it, you're losing all that hit points that it otherwise still had. So you might as well get some value from that. Just kind of my thoughts there. But a ton of balloons left up, great hit. Town Hall 11, you know, it is, I would say it's probably still harder than Town Hall 10, but it's definitely been very leveled, and we're seeing hit rates at Town Hall 11 pretty similar to Town Hall 10s. I'd say Town Hall 10s in some clans, though, is higher, and it is still easier. Let's go ahead and take a look at this one Town Hall 10 I want to show you guys, number 31 here. This one was a, once again, Sui hero, and I think this is something people should be practicing more. It's the kind of thing where you kind of start to get a feel for it. Just do friendly challenges, don't even plan that much, just kirk up the army, find someone you can do these friendly challenges with if you're a Town Hall 10, and then, or even a Town Hall 11, then you start to get a feel over time, you know, how many balloons are needed for certain sections of the base. And you can start doing it without even thinking about it too much. You just kind of get the feel for balloons, kind of how they work, and how these defenses work at taking them out. So it's just kind of a process. You can fail a lot at first and think you'll never get it, but it comes with time. So that's all I can really say. I'm still kind of, I've gotten a lot better at LaLoon the last few months, but you know, I still am learning stuff as I watch these attacks as well, because there's a lot of nuances to it. A very nice battle blimp value here. I mean, it's cutting across the base, it's tanking two air defenses, and right there, Hound comes out, and it'll continue to tank even longer. So, great value. One tip as to when you want to use that CC Lava Hound, if it's going to go to an air defense that's not in range of a single Inferno, that's definitely a good indicator of maybe you should use a CC, or a CC Hound in your battle blimp. And the reason for that is if the single Inferno is going to lock on, it doesn't matter if it's level 2 or level 3, I guess at Town Hall 10, or level, what is it, 6, 5, whatever the max is. I think it might be level 6 now. It doesn't matter. The single Inferno will take it out in a pretty similar amount of time anyway. But however, if it's only on an air defense and then being targeted by wizard towers, archer towers, anything that's not an Inferno, especially the queen, if you're tanking the queen, that's a great use for it. Then you're going to get the full value of that extra hit points it has. So that's when you want to consider using it, when it's tanking somewhere away from those single Infernos. Otherwise, you might be better off bringing balloons in the siege machine. Just make sure the balloons don't get too far out in front of your lava hounds and of the rest of your air part of your attack, because that can happen if the siege machine darts across the base. So keep that in mind, but that's pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed the attacks. Once again, good war to buy forever. It's always fun having these weekend wars, planning on Discord and stuff, but it was definitely disappointing. And we're kind of go back to the drawing board, make some changes, and just kind of get a better feel, kind of get the clan going again. We still, you know, Genesis has kind of been a clan that's remaking itself constantly. So we have new members, we have old members. We're just going to get that chemistry there, and I think we should have a good performance in the weekend to come. I think our last of the placement or the trial wars or whatever they're calling them. So yeah, you guys will see some more on the channel, and I'll see you guys then. Bisectatron out.